John was born and raised on a farm not far from Launceston.
Round up the animals, John. Get them in the barn for the night.
Right there.
He was a gifted student at school, knew all the answers and more.
2 times 2, cute.
4.
3 times 4 minus 2, cute.
10.
80 divided by 5 plus 23 equals cute.
39.
He was always looking at the stars, he was. John gained a scholarship to Cambridge. After he graduated, he returned to the farm in Cornwall. He was determined to find out why Uranus moved in a different way from the other planets.
This is my memorandum. I must find out why the planet Uranus acts differently to the other planets. There must be another planet out there.
He worked hard to find the new solution. Finally, he came up with a solution and told James Challis, his boss at the Cambridge Observatory.
Look, sir, I found the mystery planet.
Really?
Yes, sir, you must look for it.
Challis didn't look for the planet.
After all, no one had ever found a planet by using maths before.
He took his solution to the most important astronomer in Britain, George Airy.
Oh, what's this now? Oh, I'll look at this some other time.
He finally got around to having a look at the document. Airy wrote to Cooch, asking for more detail. He never got around to answering that letter. Meanwhile, in France, astronomers were interested in the same oddity. Urbain Le Verrier was asked to do some research.
I must get to work immediately. Where is the mystery planet?
Airy had a look at Le Verrier's paper and was impressed.
Maybe John was right after all. Maybe I need to look at his workings again.
I did not know about John Cooch's work.
I didn't know about Le Verrier's work.
Airy finally asked Challis to look for the planet in the place John predicted. You can spot planets through a telescope. They also move, unlike the stars.
We must keep this finding secret.
Yes, definitely.
Le Verrier also felt it was time to start looking.
Can we use the most powerful telescopes?
Le Verrier asked John Galley, whilst in Berlin, to look through his telescope to find the planet.
We found it. On the same night as well.
Zut alors!
Zut alors! He found it.
Fantastique!
Meanwhile, Challis realised he had actually found it, but not realised. Sir John Herschel decided to write about John Couch Adams's work in a newspaper.
It's an outrage.
He's trying to steal our ideas. We must write about it in these French papers.
Everyone saw John's calculations and saw they were different from Le Verrier's, but they had both reached the same conclusion. The two men decided to share the credit for their discovery.
Let us name the planet.
Janus, Oceanus,
or what about Le Verrier?
What about Neptune?